Morning, lady boys and girls.
Welcome to our Sunday worship service. We are so glad that you are here to join us in worship our Lord Savior Jesus Christ. As we worship together, let's remember how much God loves us and we are called to love one another as Christ loves us. Let us begin our worship service with a heart full of gratitude and praise for all that God has done for us. Let's begin our service with
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful Sunday and for allowing us to come together to worship you. Thank you for being with us as we sing praise songs for you and hear stories from your word. Please help us to understand more about you and your love for us. We pray that you would speak to us through your word. Please pour your blessings upon our worship and please bless our church and community. So may your love and grace shine through us and may Jesus be the light in the darkness for those who do not yet know you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God always hears us and is with us. The story of Moses and the Israelites reminds us that God is always with his people, even in the middle of great suffering and injustice. He saved Moses as a baby and called him to lead his people out of slavery, showing his power through miraculous signs. God fulfilled his promises to his people, leading them out of Egypt and into the promised land. We can be confident that God is still with us today, no matter what challenges we face. He hears our prayers and knows our struggles, and he has a plan for each one of us. Each one of us has a unique calling to fulfill. And we can trust that God will give us the strength and courage to do it. The story of Moses points to a greater calling and rescue, the call of Jesus to come to earth to save his people. Through his death and resurrection, Jesus offers us eternal life and the forgiveness of our sins. We can trust in God's faithfulness. God always keeps his promises because he is faithful. The story of Exodus chapter 1 through 4 teaches us that God hears the cries of his people and is faithful to rescue them. Joseph's despite Moses' doubts and questions, God reassured him with miraculous signs and sent Aaron to help. This story reminds us when God calls us, we may feel we're not perfect, we are imperfect, but we can trust in His power and faithfulness. With God on our side, we can do all things and overcome any challenges. Let's read Numbers 20:19, which says that God is not human that he should lie, not a human being that he should change his mind. Does he speak and then act? Does he promise and not fulfill? In this verse, the prophet Balaam declares that God is not a human who can lie and change his mind. This verse reminds us God's character is unchanging, and his love and faithfulness toward us never waver. Our God is faithful. Let's read today's Christ Connection all together. God saved Moses' life and called him to rescue the people from the slavery. The calling of Moses leads to a greater calling, as he loves Jesus to come to us. promises because He is faithful.
Joseph's family in Egypt grew even after Joseph, his brothers, and their families died. All the people in this family were known as Israelites because they came from Joseph's father, Jacob, who was also called Israel. When a new pharaoh came to power in Egypt, he was afraid of the Israelites. Pharaoh worried they would all fight against him. So Pharaoh made the Israelites slaves, and he gave them very hard work to do. Still, their families grew. So Pharaoh ordered for all their baby boys to be killed. Around this time, a woman gave birth to a son. She hid him as long as she could, and then she put him in a basket and set the basket along the bank of the Nile River. Soon, Pharaoh's daughter went to the river to take a bath. She found the baby and felt sorry for him. Pharaoh's daughter wanted the baby to be her son. The princess named the baby Moses. Moses grew up as a prince in Egypt. One day, he saw an Egyptian man mistreating an Israelite man. Moses killed the Egyptian and then fled from Egypt. He worked as a shepherd in another land for many years. Back in Egypt, the Israelite people were miserable. They cried out to God, and God heard them. He had a plan to take them. One day, Moses saw a bush on fire. The bush was not burning up. Suddenly, God called from the bush, "Moses, Moses." Moses replied, "Here I am." God told Moses to take off his sandals because Moses was standing on holy ground. Then God said, "I have seen how my people are suffering. I want you to lead them out of Egypt to a good land I have for them." "What if they ask for your name?" Moses said. "What should I tell them?" "I am who I am," God said. "Tell them I am has sent me to you." What if they don't believe me?" Moses asked. So God gave Moses three miraculous signs to prove that God had appeared to him. Moses' staff would turn into a snake. His hand would become diseased and then healed. And water from the river would turn into blood. But Moses still made excuses. He said, "Please send someone else." God was angry, but agreed to send Moses' brother, Aaron, with him. So Moses went to Egypt. God saved Moses' life and called him to rescue God's people from slavery. The calling of Moses points to a greater calling and rescue, the call of Jesus to come to earth to save God's people. Jesus gave up his life to save us from slavery to sin.
God always hears us and is with us. The story of Moses and Israelites reminds us that God is always with his people, even in the middle of great suffering and injustice. He saved Moses as a baby and called him to lead his people out of slavery, showing his power through miraculous signs. God fulfilled his promises to his people, leading them out of Egypt and into the promised land. We can be confident that God is still with us today, no matter what challenges we face. He hears our prayers and knows our struggles, and he has a plan for each one of us. Each one of us has a unique calling to fulfill, and we can trust that God will give us the strength and courage to follow it. The story of Moses points to a greater calling and rescue, the call of Jesus to come to earth to save God's people. Through his death and resurrection, Jesus offers us eternal life and the forgiveness of our sins. We can trust in God's faithfulness and know that he is always with us, guiding us and giving us the strength to face whatever comes our way. God always keeps his promises because he is faithful. The story of Exodus chapter 1 through 4 teaches us that God hears the cries of his people and is faithful to rescue them.
Joseph's family, the Israelites, suffered as slaves in Egypt, but God had a plan to rescue them.
Despite Moses' doubts and questions, God reassured him with miraculous signs and sent Aaron to help him. This story reminds us when God calls us, we may feel we are not perfect, we are imperfect, but we can trust in His power and faithfulness. With God on our side, we can do all things and overcome any challenges that come our way. Let's read Numbers 23:19, which says that God is not human that He should lie, not a human being that He should change His mind. Does He speak and then not act? Does He promise and not fulfill? Amen. In this verse, the prophet Balaam declares that God is not like a human being who can lie or change their mind. This verse reminds us that God's character is unchanging and His love and faithfulness toward us never waver. Our God is trustworthy. Let's read today's Christ Connection all together.
God saved Moses' life and called him to rescue God's people from slavery. The calling of Moses points to a greater calling and rescue, the call of Jesus to come to earth to save God's people. Jesus gave up His life to save us from slavery to sin. God always keeps His promises because He is faithful.